Hello friends, I hope that you're having a great day. Today we're gonna be crafting some shabby chic decor. It's probably my favorite decor to look at. I used to have tons of it, but I love to craft it. I love to look at it. So let's make some today. In this first DIY, we're gonna be starting with this piece of resin, this frame that I poured with this IOD mold. It has two frames. We're gonna be using both of these in these DIYs today. Also, this beautiful napkin that my friend Myra from Farm Fresh Designs 59 sent me. I'm gonna use the part of this napkin with the flowers in the center part of the frame, and I'm gonna use this color blue on the outside. So I mixed Hey Sailor and mermaid tail together to get this beautiful color of blue. I'm gonna paint the outside of the frame with it all the way around, and I'm gonna set it aside and let it dry. And then I'm going to separate all the plies of this beautiful napkin, and I've cut it down just to use the part that I wanted, and I'm going to put this little napkin there. I'm gonna press it down so I can tell where I need to cut, and I'm going to cut it down to fit inside this little frame, just like so. Now, I'm going to spray a little water over here. I'm gonna wet my finger, and I'm gonna get the edge of this napkin wet. There are a million different ways that you can do this. I just happened along this way, and I loved it. Now, I'm on a silicone mat, and so it has a little bit of that rubbery give to it. So the edge of my napkin is wet, and I just am pressing down firmly and pulling out on that little napkin, and it's tearing that edge away just beautifully, as you can see there. And so I'm kind of measuring to see how much I need to tear away. Now I'm using crinoline by DIY to paint the inside of the frame, so it will give us a beautiful background for our napkin. Now I'm going to use some Mod Podge, and I'm going to put a healthy coat of Mod Podge on here. Now you know my favorite method to Mod Podge is the iron-on method, which I don't think was going to work for me on this project. And it was a tiny little piece, so I just put it on here and used the method that I use when I'm going to use this method. How many times can I say the word method? And I'm just going to use a little piece of saran wrap. Now, it was a little bit too long. I didn't measure that great, so I just wet the edge and took some tweezers and pulled it off, and it worked beautifully. Now, I'm making sure that that's nice and dry, and I'm going to take some white wax by DIY, and I'm rubbing it on the back of my hand to get the excess off or to smooth it into the bristles really nicely. And I'm going to give the front of this all a coat of white wax by DIY, even across the napkin. Now, when I decoupage with napkins or anything like that, I like to seal it with DIY wax versus putting Mod Podge on top so that I don't get all those wrinkles. Now I'm going to just put this DIY white wax all down in the details of this beautiful little frame. The IOD sisters do such a beautiful job getting all those details in their molds. And then whenever I finish getting as much in there as I want, I'm going to take a scrap little piece of an old t-shirt that I cut up, and I'm going to just buff it. So I'm going to try to get as much off of the top surface and leave as much as I can down in the details. And I absolutely adore this look. It looks so shabby chic to me, and I just love it. So you're going to see how all those details pop. Now, I had this little easel from Dollar Tree, and this one came from Dollar Tree or Hobby Lobby. I don't think they're exactly the same, but I stained it with some antique wax, and that's how I'm going to display my little frame. Looks like it belongs in an art gallery, in my opinion. For our next DIY, we're going to start with this picture frame that my sister gave me in a box of goodies that she had that she was getting rid of, and we're just going to disassemble it. I got rid of the glass, and I'm going to take this little piece of
cardboard and some black cardstock. I'm going to use a purple glue stick. You can use any kind of glue stick, any kind of adhesive that you want. Double stick tape would work. And I'm going to adhere the black cardstock onto the cardboard. Now, this little cardboard's the piece that came in the picture frame, so we're just going to stick it right back in there, just like so, and make sure that it fits. Now, originally, that's all I was going to do to it. Then I decided to zhuzh it up a little bit and put that silver, beautiful, sparkly silver ribbon and hot glue that down. Now, you can see to the left that little frame. I did the exact same procedure method. I'm going to use the word method again to make it as I did the blue one. I just did not get it on camera. So my friend Victoria West, she's a viewer who I met on the Crafting Cruise getaway, who lives about 40-45 minutes from me, came over and crafted with me a few weeks ago. And we were pouring molds because she had never done that with resin before. And I poured this mold, and as she was painting the molds that she poured, I just was painting this one and just kind of creating over on the side. And I decided I absolutely loved the way this turned out, and I didn't record it. So I made the blue one to show you how I did it, but this one I did exactly the same method. So I'm just going to hot glue this down to the center of this little frame with the beautiful little silver ribbon on it. And this was such an easy DIY, but I think it is absolutely gorgeous. You're going to have to let me know what you think about this. This is kind of a different type of shabby chic, but I still think it's beautiful. I did think that the frame needed a little something. I did like it just like this. So I took some silver rub and buff, and I rubbed some around the edges. And at one point, I had too much. You can see on the right side there, I had a little too much. And all I did was take a tissue, and I rubbed some of it back. And it kind of came off this frame a little bit. It hadn't quite cured yet. And so I rubbed some back, and then I rubbed a little bit extra in. And you'll see in the end, it turned out just beautiful.
If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Kendra. You're watching Late Night Creations. I'm so glad that you popped in. I'm so glad you found my channel. If you're a returning viewer, you know the drill. I'm glad you're here. Be sure that you give this video a thumbs up. Be sure you drop a comment, even if it's an emoji. Maybe you don't know what to say. Maybe you're not one to normally comment. Just drop an emoji. We're trying to get to 10,000 subscribers, so make sure you're subscribed, because I have an awesome giveaway that we're going to do when we get to 10,000 subscribers. And I've got it all boxed up and ready to send to some lucky winner. It's 10 of my favorite Can't Craft Without items. Yeah, you're going to want this. You're going to want this prize. So let's get back to crafting. And that's what we're here for.
We are going to take some beadboard by DIY, and we are going to put one coat on this plate from Dollar Tree that we had previously put two coats of Slick Stick by Dixie Belle. Slick Stick. Is that what it's called? Slick Stick. I just had it on the screen. I followed the instructions with that product, and it allows you to be able to paint on slick surfaces and the paint adhere. And so you saw that I just pounced that on there, and it gave it a little texture, and now it's completely dry. And I'm going to use the Veranda stamp by IOD. It is the new release for this spring, and the China Blue ink. Now, you see how I bent it and did it in the middle, and then, yeah, I don't know why I did that, but the plate is curved, and I just felt like it would work better that way. I was really afraid that this would not stamp on there good, but look at it. There's only one little place it didn't stamp on good, but I was okay with that. I was really okay with that. Now, I'm just going back, and I'm just going to take one little corner of that and kind of extend that out over the edge, and I think it turned out great. So I'm going to let that dry. While I'm letting that dry, I'm going to take this mold that I did this. I cannot remember the name of this mold by IOD. Is it called Florets? I don't remember what this is called. But the whole thing is this big rosettes. Anyway, it's this big, huge mold full of flowers. And so I just poured it with resin and then I heated it up a little bit where I wanted to cut it. And I just took my X-Acto knife and just cut the pieces that I wanted. And so I cut out this piece. I'm using a custom color that I mixed, which was similar to that last frame we did. And then I'm using this, I believe it's Aviary by DIY, and painting the leaves. I'm just going in with a little brush and I'm just kind of taking my time just painting this. And it did not really take that long. And I love to paint. So I didn't mind. I didn't mind taking a little bit of time to paint this, and it really wasn't hard at all. And you'll notice that as I'm painting, I rest my pinky or my hand on part of the project. See my pinky rested there? I'll rest my pinky or my hand on my project to steady my hand. Okay, so you can see where I'm going with this. I'm going to rest that on there. I'm going to put that in the middle. I'm resting. I'm resting that pinky. I've got resting on the brain. I'm going to take this little piece of a makeup sponge and I'm going to go all the way around this plate with that China blue ink, just all the way around the edge, just to give it a little, just outline it a little bit. I kind of like projects to be outlined a little bit sometimes. So I'm just going to outline that, and I think that just kind of finishes it off. Now I'm going to take Vintage Linen by DIY Paint and just give this beautiful little rose piece a dry brush. I'm just going to dry brush all over it with this little chippy. It's an old stencil brush that I've kind of worn out, and I'm just going to dry brush all the tops of the leaves and the flowers. I'm trying not to get it down in the depths of it so that we have some shadows down in there and have some dark areas down in there. Just try to dry brush it and give it some dimension. Okay, now we are going to put a good, nice coat of clear wax all over this plate to seal in that paint. We always want to seal our DIY paints because they are clay-based, and they will come up if they get too much moisture. They will bleed and all that good stuff, so we want to protect all the work that we've done. We're going to give our resin piece a nice, good coat of the DIY clear wax as well. Now we are going to see where we're going to place our little rosy resin piece, and then we are going to make a little shabby bow. I had these little piece of scraps, which I've been using and using. They were from leftover fabric from a curtain I made, a little shabby curtain I made for my salon, and I just cut some small little strips, and I'm going to tie a knot in the middle with some embroidery thread that is white, and I'm going to just fluff it and pull the little pieces kind of all together, trim off the excess little ribbon. I'm going to fluff it, pull all the little pieces out, and we're going to stick it up in the corner of this plate and just add a little bit of shabby chicness to this decor piece. Now I'm going to add some hot glue, quite a bit of globs of hot glue on the back of this, because I want this to stick to this plate really nicely. And now we're going to glue our little bow to it. And this one is finished. You'll have to let me know what you think about this one. Actually, I added another little piece. Sorry, I tied a knot in the middle of one piece and I'm going to stick it in the middle, just to make it look more finished. Okay, now we're done. Let me know what you think about this one. It's a little bit different and unique, but I'm gonna put it on an easel and I think it just looks precious. For this DIY, I grabbed my Mod Podge and I put it all over this glass trivet that I picked up at Dollar Tree. Just one of those simple glass trivets, and I'm going to set it aside to dry. In the meantime, I have these two resin pieces that my friend Myra over at Farm Fresh Designs 59 sent me. She's sending me all kinds of stuff, y'all. She is a sweet friend. Now, I did not show you how I painted the blue one, but it was a custom color that I mixed. I think it was the same color that I mixed up for that frame, actually. And then I mixed up some cowgirl coral, and I added a little bit of carnival red to it because I wanted it to match the colors in that napkin that we used earlier, because in that one with the blue frame, because we're going to use that same napkin again. And so I'm going to paint this beautiful little perfume bottle with it, and then the little squeezy poofer part. I don't know if that has a technical name or not, but we're going to call it the little squeezy poofer part to the little atomizer. We're going to paint it a queen bee, as well as some of the little parts of this that I thought should be gold, because we're going to make these some fancy little perfume bottles. I like to paint them first with queen bee and then go back in with some metallic acrylic paint that I have. I don't have any real gold rub and buff. I do have some ordered. I ordered it from Sammy over at unicorndustdesigns.com. That's where I get all my DIY paint, Saltwash, IOD products. So if you're interested in ordering some of those products, pop on over to her website. She has a lot of really good things over on her website. Go over there and shop. You won't be disappointed. You'll find all kinds of things you need. Trust me. Okay, so you can see that I'm using that metallic acrylic paint, and I'm going over that queen bee just to give it that metallic look. Okay, so I'm peeling apart my napkin to just have that top ply. Now, you see I put it face down because I'm going to flip this glass piece over so that we're using the front of it, okay? So it'll all make sense, I promise. And then it's all adhered down. I'm using the iron-on method. And then I'm taking a softer nail file, and I'm filing away that little napkin. Now, if I used my rough one, it really made a rough edge, and I wanted this to have a smooth edge. Now, I'm taking some clear wax by DIY, and I'm sealing that napkin down to my project. I'm sealing it in all around the edges and all over the back side of this. Like I said, I do not want to put any wet Mod Podge on that and cause wrinkling. That's why I use the iron-on method, is because I don't like the wrinkles and the bubbles. So let's make this all nice and smooth. Okay, now that we're done with that, let's grab our Vintage Linen by DIY, and we're going to very lightly dry brush over all those details, because these molds need to have the details brought out. Did you see that little flash? We were having a really bad storm this night, and my electricity kept flickering, and I didn't take that out because I wanted to say, hey, do you see that my lights are flickering from the electricity? And if I would have left the original audio in here, you would have heard it really thundering loud. It was thundering so loudly that night. It was just booming out there. It was quite a lightning show in the sky. I love to see it lightning in the sky, and it just shows God's power and His just the glory in nature. God is amazing how all the things work together in nature. I love to watch storms. Okay, now we're going to take our clear DIY wax, and we are going to wax our products and seal that paint in. And you see me rub it on my hand like that, so I'm getting it all over the bristles, and then I can go back on my hand and get a little bit more if I need more, if I use it all up in there. But if I get it all distributed in there good, it usually lasts me pretty good. Okay, let's assemble this thing. This is what we're going to use. I almost used this mold to put a border across the top and the bottom, but I didn't want to keep using molds. I wanted some other textures. So I have these sheer ribbons that I bought from Shein. And then this came from the Dollar Tree. The lace crochet ribbon came from Dollar Tree. And we're just going to put some across the top, and we're going to put some across the bottom. So I'm going to measure it out and just cut it the length that we need. There we go. And then I'm going to make another little messy bow, and I'm going to use some of that peachy color because I thought it matched some of the flowers in that napkin. And then I'm going to use the little kind of ivory off-white and some more of that little crocheted lace. And then I just cut a little strip of that sheer ribbon, and I'm going to just tie a little knot in the middle to make that little bow. I'm just going to get it right, make sure I have it right in the center. Now I'm just going to take some of that quick bond, and I'm going to smear it once I get that little piece of hot glue off there and put it down. Now I didn't care if it came all the way out to the edge in the middle because, yeah, I just didn't care. It'll be fine. I'm going to use that, and I'm going to use just a tad little bit of hot glue with that lace ribbon because it's a little bit thicker, and I wanted to make sure it stuck really good. Oh, I just think this looks so pretty on this piece of glass. And then I'm going to flip it over and cut the excess off. I don't even know if I showed that or not. And then I'm kind of figuring out my placement here, how I want everything placed before I start gluing it down. I'm going to use some of the Tap Bond Quick and Thick and some hot glue here because, you know, the hot glue will give it a quick fix. I want to say a quick fix. It will give it a quick hold, but it doesn't always hold good on glass, but the tight bond will hold good on the glass forever and ever, or as long as I want it to anyway. So this is a good combination. You just don't want the two glues to mix because they don't mix well. They don't play well together. Okay, let's glue this little bow up top. And I had a couple little pieces that didn't want to lay exactly where I wanted them to, so I just used a little hot glue to convince them to stay where I wanted them to. I also propped this up on a little easel. I also used my little dowel stand that I made on the Crafty Cruise Getaway and propped it up against that as well. So let me know what you think about this one.
I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for sticking around to the end. But I want you to most of all remember to be still and know that He is God.